Greetings and welcome to all of our friends who are joining us this evening for this very special event. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Sister Kathleen Mache. I am the Provincial Superior of the Sisters of the Holy Family of Nazareth. It is with great pleasure that I welcome you to our CSFN 2022 Stay at Home Social, Sweet Memories. When we first began our planning in 2022, we were confident that we would be able to have an in-person event and to see our friends in person once again. Unfortunately, things didn't quite work out that way. We want nothing more than to preserve the safety of our sisters and you, our friends. And for that reason, we made the decision to hold a virtual event again this year. From the comfort and safety of our homes, we can continue to celebrate with one another. This year, we have chosen to look back at all the wonderful times we shared with you and with one another over the years. We are celebrating all of the sweet memories we have made, knowing that we will continue to create new memories. The special moments we have shared mean so much to all of us, and we cherish them. We hope you enjoy this evening's program, which will feature photos and music from our sisters, as well as an update on the great generosity you have shown in supporting our Ukrainian Relief Fund, and a special appearance by Vicky Quade of Nuns for Fun Entertainment. Over the years, you have been such a great blessing to our sisters. We are thankful each and every day that the Lord sought fit to bring kind-hearted and generous people into our lives. People who support our charism and mission of the Sisters of the Holy Family of Nazareth. It is because of your great generosity that we are able to continue to provide and care for our aging and retired sisters. On behalf of all the sisters, I would like to offer you our most heartfelt thanks. Be assured that our prayers are with you now and always. Sit back and enjoy the program.
We begin this evening, as we begin everything, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Father, we praise you for this event, Sweet Memories. And we thank you for those who have spent months preparing it. We know that when two or three gather together in your name, you are there. So, we have many more gathered in your name to support our efforts to serve families. Please bless each person present with us and bless each member of their families. We have a human agenda for this event. Your agenda is divine. We thank you for your presence at this time, and we ask for blessings on our future. You know every person who contributed to the growth of Nazareth. You know every person who collaborated in the past. And you know every person who worked to organize Sweet Memories. You know our hearts. And you granted the graces needed, Father. And the results are much greater than we can ever imagine. Your faithfulness endures throughout all ages. May you be praised. Our prayer today is that your will be done through this event. Take our 5 loaves and 2 fish and multiply our efforts as only you can. Steer our intentions to align with the life and example of the Holy Family of Nazareth. May all glory go to you when we reach the finish line united in your love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Good evening, friends, relatives, and sisters. I'm Kathy Barth, Director of Development for the Holy Family Province. Thank you for joining us tonight for our virtual CSFN social. We hope you are enjoying the presentations so far. The proceeds from this evening's event will benefit our elder sisters living at Mount Nazareth and throughout the U.S. I'd like to recognize a few of the people who helped us put this evening together. First, our sisters who supplied photos, videos, and prayers for a successful evening. Sister Mary Ellen, who provided our prayer. Rachel and Sister Angela from the communications office who helped us with publicizing this event. Thanks too to Heidi and Amanda from our development office, without whose creativity and determination we would not be here this evening. Most importantly, I'd like to thank our sponsors and donors whose extraordinarily generous and faithful support through the years has helped us do so many things for our sisters. We are also grateful for those of you who donated to our Ukrainian Refugee Fund. The proceeds from this fund will be sent to our sisters in Ukraine and Poland who are assisting with the needs of the Ukrainian refugees there. If you'd like to donate now, you can click on the donate button on our Facebook page, go to our website and click donate, or mail in a donation to our development office. Once again, I'd like to thank you for joining us this evening, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the show. Please remember that our sisters hold you and your loved ones in prayer always. Thank you.
Hi, everybody. Hello, hello, hello. You know, I am so happy that you have asked me to come and talk about your wonderful conference, your Sweet Memories. I just think Sweet Memories is the perfect name. And I thought, well, let's talk about Halloween, because what could be more sweet than the Halloween memories that we have? I just have to tell you, though, I was on my way over from the convent, and there were some people out passing these out, and they said, great costume. I didn't have the heart to tell them, but look, I mean, this could be every day for me, you know, which is wonderful because, you know, I'll take this back. We'll eat 3 bags of candy by the time Halloween actually gets here. But anyway, so yeah, let's just chit chat a little bit about what we want to accomplish today. And I think we just want to take a look at the holiday, right? Because this is our memory of cool nights, especially if you grew up in the Midwest or then you guys in the Philadelphia area, or if you grew up and anywhere that really got into the celebration of Halloween and trick-or-treating. Now, a lot of people think that Catholics and Halloween do not mix. That is not true. You want to know why? Because we believe in evil. Evil exists, just like it does at Halloween. We believe in gluttony, right? You know, we have St. Charles Borromeo, who's the patron saint of people with eating disorders or people who eat too much. And we can certainly do that over the Halloween season. And then we have the Virgin Mary appearing to children all across the world. Is that not a ghost sighting? Of course that is. You know, Mary could be a superhero that she appears so many times. So Halloween fits exactly with what we remember and we celebrate. So let's talk about little elements of Halloween. I would say that trick-or-treating has got to be it, right? So trick-or-treating is wonderful when it comes to the costumes. I remember those hard masks. Remember the hard mask costumes? The costume where the flimsy body of the costume, man, if anyone smoked around you, you'd go up like a flame. But and it had that hard mask. So I got one. I got one when I was about 10 years old. I could not believe that my mother actually sprung for the money to buy it, because otherwise we were a ghost, you know, sheet with a couple holes. We were, like one year she made me into a Native American with a whole costume, which I don't think you could do today. But the one year she decided that she was going to buy me a costume, and I was Cinderella with the little gold hair and the pretty little blue costume. But those masks, anyone here who remembers those masks, they were so hard that you couldn't see hardly out of the eyes. So you had to be careful. You look one way, you could look the other way. And you had to run across the street, hoping that you weren't going to get, you know, hit by a truck. So when she realized that, the next year, she decided, by then my little brother was old enough to go out trick-or-treating. So she sent me out with my little brother. And we got dressed up. We were Sonny and Cher. He was short, I was taller. And we totally dressed up. I had a black wig. I had cool bell-bottom jeans on. I had taken one of my father's vests and I didn't tell him. And I fringed it, you know, so I figured he didn't really want it back after that. And my little brother went, we got him a little black wig and we fixed it up and everything. And he looked adorable. And we went trick-or-treating. And of course, we always had to go over to the convent. We always had to visit the nuns first in the neighborhood before you really went around the blocks. So I knocked on the convent door and Sister Evangeline came to the door and she said, oh, look who we have here. Who are you? Are you Mary Magdalene? And I said, Mary Magdalene? I'm not Mary Magdalene. I am Cher of Sonny and Cher. And she said, oh, she had no idea what I was talking about. And she just looked at me and said, oh, Mary Magdalene. But now you're calling yourself Mary Cher. That's okay. And who is this? This is the baby Jesus? Is this you're taking Jesus around? It was just like, I just thought, forget it. They are never going to get my Sonny and Cher costume. And the nuns would always end up giving you like an apple. They felt like an apple was a little better for you. And then what would we do? We'd immediately leave the convent and then we'd find somebody young and we'd toss the apple to them. But the favorite candies, I had two favorite candies for Halloween that I oddly really liked. I liked Peeps because they were left over from Easter. Anybody who had them on the Easter basket left them over. And a soft peep doesn't taste that good. But when you got an old, like 6-month-old hard peep, they tasted actually pretty good. And many of you probably do know this, but there is a slight religious connection to Peeps. Peeps are marshmallow, and they're made in a place in Pennsylvania that is perfectly named. They are made in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, which I think is just perfect. And now you can get Peeps for Halloween. In fact, I just found. Oh, here, I have a picture. Look, I got a picture. Look at the Peeps. Look. Ah, remember them? Oh, and now they have Halloween Peeps. They have pumpkin Peeps and Frankenstein Peeps, and for Easter you can get Easter Peeps. You can get Santa Claus Peeps for Christmas. Peeps are a huge industry, so that's the one candy I really like getting. The second candy we loved getting was Necco wafers. Necco wafers. Oh, here, I got another picture. Look at the Necco. Remember these Necco wafers? Of course you do. Of course you do. We all loved Necco wafers because why? Because we played the communion game. Remember? That was where you and your whole neighborhood, we would get the whole neighborhood kids to come over, and we would pretend that we were giving out Holy Communion. And I liked it because it was one of the few chances that a girl got to be a priest. And so we would, we'd have people come over, and then they would open their mouths, and we would put the peep in there. I would have the peep. I would put a peep in there for sure because I love peeps. But no, we would put the little Necco wafer in there. That was great. So these are just sweet memories of growing up Catholic, memories of Halloween. I also wanted to talk about Halloween movies because I think movies are really great. So, especially horror movies, but certain horror movies. I don't like slasher movies. I never was a slasher film aficionado. I just don't like them. But look, I found these. Well, first of all, I should tell you. So I have a 92-year-old nun friend. She's from a different order. Her name is Sister Virginette. And Sister Virginette scours resale shops and things for me because our convent is called Nuns for Fun Entertainment, Nuns for Fun. And then we have this entertainment aspect of it. So we call ourselves the Sisters of Nuns for Fun. And I am Sister Vicky. I don't know that I introduced myself to you, but I am Sister Vicky from Nuns for Fun. And Sister Virginette, who is here in Chicago, because I'm doing this to you, saying hello to you from Chicago, goes to all the resale shops and she buys these. And we do talks, and we actually perform on a stage here in Chicago, and around the world. We do performances around the world. And we talk about all sorts of different things. And right now we're talking about Halloween. So I pulled out Sister Virginette's Halloween collection. This is all the classics. Bela Lugosi is on here. Vincent Price. These are the. I mean, I don't mind vampire movies like this because they don't show you that much. Oh, look at this. Oh, Bela Lugosi, the bat, the devil bat. Oh, the devil bat. Then you get into now. This is not a bad one. Walking Dead, The Walking Dead, zombies. Not. I like things that are not too terribly scary or too terribly violent. But here's another one. Look at this Frailty. This is actually a really good film. This got a surprise ending to it. So if you ever go online, if you can do that, and you can look up Frailty. I know that a lot of you probably don't like horror films. Slasher films, almost every slasher film is condemned by the Catholic Church. Are you aware of that? Almost every slasher film. However, the priests and the bishops who review movies for the Vatican do tend to like some of the classics. So you could watch the original Frankenstein, the original Mummy, things like that. And you would not, it would not be considered a sin. But I would not watch some of the other movies that would not make it. So you can always go online and check that out before you, you rent a movie. You don't want to rent a movie and then realize you can't watch it. Okay, so before I leave, I want to leave with a little story. Okay, so I'd like to leave with a little ghost story. Because, you know, you gotta love. Okay, I have a little ghost. Look at this. This is what we put in the yard over at the convent. We put this little character, this little ghost character in the yard. Because it's kind of cute, you know. This is okay to do something with. But a little ghost story. Okay, so this, I heard this story from, again, at one of the convents that I like to be connected to here. It involves a nun named Sister Angelica. So Sister Angelica, she lived until she was about 97 years old. And she was old enough that she could still, or actually young enough that she could still do a few things around the convent. But she was so old that they basically had to make sure that she got into her room safely. And in the last year of her life or so, she just stayed in that room. And then she died. Sister Angelica died in that room. After a while, the other nuns realized that there was a cold spot in the room. The room was very, very, very cold. And they decided that the novices would end up being put into that room. And the nuns just thought that maybe Sister Angelica was there to cause some mischief. And so after a while, the novices refused to stay in the room. And so Sister Angelica, what they did is they ended up making that room into storage. So Sister Angelica had to stay in storage. And after that, anytime they went in there, Sister Angelica would push something out of the way so that one of the nuns would end up tripping. And they just called that Angelica's room. So I have a feeling that some of you have similar ghost stories. And those are sweet memories, too. And they're great things to share with people. So tell your ghost stories because they're really, really fun. Anyway, I'm going to go for now. I love so much sharing something with you all about the memories. And have a wonderful meeting. Take care.
My sweet memories. I think one of the most important one is when I first came to United States and arrived in Philadelphia, started college right away and with no English. And it was really beautiful, and how sisters in the community that I live were helping me in many different ways. From checking my papers to study with me a little bit, giving me advice how to study. And then when I graduated, and it was really nice to see that every step of my education here in the United States, there's always sisters involved in it. And then when I came here to Pittsburgh, I really truly miss Sister Kathleen. She was the one who always waited for me when I came home, and I only put the key in the keyhole, open the door, and I hear, "Daniela, is that you?" And then we have a chit chat. So I really, really, you know, miss her. And I also, you know, I'm always grateful to all the sisters for the support they have given me throughout the years here in the States.
that comes to me at this time is, first of all, when we became postulants, that was a few years ago.
Yeah.
Sister Janice was in the group with me and many others, and we were considered a gift to the new provincial, Sister Mary Caesar. So I always thank God for Sister Mary Caesar, because also she was a principal in the grade school from where I entered. That was St. Stan's in Erie. Well, the memory I'm thinking of is, there used to be a tradition in the community about observing days of black fast, you know, when you couldn't have milk and different kind of products like this. So I happened to have the honor of going to have my novitiate in Rome. And Sister Dorothy Renee went with me, and we were in New York City at the convent Our Lady of Częstochowa. I had never been to New York. I was dying to see the Empire State Building. And of course, we couldn't go out anyplace because we were novices. And so we had the honor of helping the sister in the kitchen that day. So that's what we did. We spent the day helping the cook sister. The day we were leaving the States for Rome was September 15th, which is a Black Fast Day. So we came down to the dining room. What did I know about Black Fast? Not too much. And so the superior announces, in honor of the sisters leaving for Rome, we are not going to have Black Fast for breakfast. So how about that?
Wow.
I'm telling you.
That's a sweet memory.
So that's very sweet.
They brought me in from the doctor, and I saw the sisters coming in with a wagon, with a wheelchair, and, you know, a ramp, you know. And it was such a beautiful, you know, experience to see the love that, you know, they had. They wanted me to be safe because I felt miserable, you know, being out of daycare, working, breaking my leg at the same time.
Today, now, we are in the process, I feel, that we're making. I feel that this is my sweet memory, today being here. But in the past, at my age, I guess, I've been thinking a lot of my parents and a lot of sweet memories of childhood, of being with my mom and dad, and lately that's been on my mind. And also a sweet and sad memory is when I used to have adoration in our chapel, you know, in the provincial aid, you know, just to be there, that was sweet. So
that is my 50th wedding. Wedding!
Well,
I was.
Look at you.
You were married to Jesus.
Yeah. That's right. There you go. That'll work.
That was so beautiful because I even had one of the girls from the Institute coming and greeting me with a bouquet of flowers. And they just popped into my head right now. But there are so many good memories, really.
Well, since we're celebrating 50th Jubilees, I was thinking back of celebrating my 50th Jubilee, and I was in Rome at that time. I was the General Treasurer. Sister Janice was there as the Superior General. But my celebration was right on my day of entrance, which was January 11th, which when I entered, it was the Feast of the Holy Family. But that year we had students from all over the third world countries because they were attending this Duquesne program. And what I remember, and was so memorable for me, was the variety of people. We're talking about relationships. Because we had relationships with all these different sisters who dressed all different ways from different countries at my Jubilee celebration. Plus, because we had renovated the General Lake, we had architects and plumbers and electricians. And then, of course, our sisters from Rome. And when I picture that chapel of all the different people from such different walks and ways of life, and I thought to myself, this was my opportunity to really relate to so many different people and to have them rejoice with me over this 50 years of religious life. And every time I look at those people, I think, all of these different people. And they were just all part of my life, particularly that year or those couple of years when we were doing so much renovation. So those, it's a sweet memory. It's something that can't really be repeated because everything just happened providentially at that time that Duquesne had that program. And so those sisters were there. And what we were doing at the general, like, just involved so many people that I just got to know that I never would have known before.
When I was told a year and a half ago that I would have to move and come to the manor, well, I was given a choice. And I said, I might as well go to the manor because I'm going to land out there in a couple of years anyhow. So I'll get break myself in. And when I came here, I was so frightened and everything. And I can honestly say, I'm learning how to relax. I am Janice. I'm learning how to relax, and things are happening, you know, to me. That the only thing I do regret is I'm not driving, and that's a big, hard thing for me. But I'm pretty well orientated to that after not driving for a year and a half.
Remember, we used to ask for prayers as people were going out of the dining room. I forget what sister, but she was saying, I humbly ask for prayers, I humbly ask for prayers. And then she says, after the important people pass, she says, help the poor, help the poor.
You know, if I have so many sweet memories, but I will divide them into two groups, my Polish sweet memories and my American sweet memories. But I'm going to probably focus more on the American one. You know, when I'm looking back, the last 12 years since I'm here, have been in the United States, I'm really lucky and blessed to have friends. You know, to have people and develop relationships. And that's what probably I cherish the most. Having, you know, people in life, then you can call them at the 3 a.m. and know that they will support you. So one of my biggest supporter and friend and mentor was Sister Francesca Only. Mm-hmm. And I have, I don't know how many sweet memories with her, but I just mentioned one fact. We were going to Pittsburgh actually for probably picnic, some kind of a Labor Day or maybe Memorial Day. We took the turnpike because it was the fastest way. Halfway through, Sister Francesca said, Cordia, there is a very famous horse. How about if we just take a turn and go to see the horse? So can we met, and I don't know, secretarian or some kind of
secretarian.
Yeah, you know, like, you know, probably better. But anyway, it took us just, she said, oh, it's just one exit left, it's not a big deal. It took us 3.5 hours to get back on the turnpike. But see, but that's what Francesca was about. I learned from her to cherish every moment, to not be afraid of dreaming big, to be persistent and grateful for people in life. I think that I got this from her.
We're from the same school, the same neighborhood. Mary Lou went to school with my younger brother. And when I went to talking to the sisters about entering community, and they said, oh, Mary Lou will make it because she's holy, but you won't. She said, you'll never make it. You'll never make it. So I said to the sisters in my house, or a couple of the sisters, I said, next year is my 50th Jubilee, and I'm going to get a tattoo that says, ha ha, I made it. So I have fond memories of sisters saying, oh, you're not going to make it. You're not, you know, you're not convent material, and you won't leave your mother and all kinds of things like that. So, Mary Lou, cheers. Here's to us.
Cheers.
We both pay
to you.
Amen.
One of the many ones is that when
when I became a superior here at the Manor, I was scared, very scared. Sister Michelle, I think, was the director at the time. I don't remember, but when my first sister died, I was devastated because I didn't know what to do. But Sister Maria was the first one to call me and say, "You need any help, I'll be there right away." And she'd done that since all my 3 years that I was here. Every time a sister died, she called me, and that was so sweet because it's a sad thing to talk about maybe, but it was sweet for me because you really helped me in my, I was so young at that time and inexperienced in being a superior. Mm-hmm. And it's such a special place like here, And that's one of the sweetest memories I have.
Dear sisters, this is my sweet memories in a poem. Sister Bogusława taught me how to hand sew and rip. Sister Daniela, to Rome we went together on a trip. Sister Esperanza, your great seek and find alphabet game. Sister Rita, the duck lonesome you did tame. Sister Nahida, the value of a GPS. Sister David, my best Advent angel, I could not guess. Sister Aditta, your woodworking and creativity. Sister Josephine, your coming with Abby to come and see. Sister Magrajata, attending your Tyler tribute and video. Sister Faustina, playing with you in rare Texas snow. Sister Emanuela, remembering your love of noodles and boba. Sister Molly Bernadette with Gaudete, one more coda. Sister Sylvia, how to get around in Tyler. Sister Encarna, by watching your dad, how to fix a computer. Sister Therese Marie, the homemade notebook with Mother Foundress. Sister Micaela, to teach me the value of cooking only with fresh. Sister Claire, you're teaching me how to use the calculator on my phone. Sister Marietta, the queen of the day book. No need for a loan. Sister Michelle Vincent taught me about getting others involved in small ways. Sister Gemma, the one who knows everything about history, any day. Sister Marta got us new numbers for the board as we sing. Sister Francesca has visions of me doing flips and other funny things. Sister Pia, great with a camera and fearless of wild animals. Sister Beata, oh, your roses are great since the weeds you did pull. Sister Janice K, the fun money games on Christmas Day. Sister Monica, to inspire us, always knows just what to say. Sister Mary Louise can lead retreats, give direction, and plan liturgies with ease. Sister Barbara Francis, for the organ lessons, she did not charge fees. Sister Maria Therese, always ready at table to tell jokes. Sister Loretta Rose has been a Catholic teacher to so many Grand Prairie folks. Sister Mary Kim, the best Vietnamese cook we've got. Now it's time to stop. That's all I've got. Happy memories. Bye.
Thank you.
I hope everyone enjoyed the program this evening, the music, the photos, and the special entertainment that was provided. Thank you so much for joining us this evening and for your support, which means so much to all of us. Thank you also to all of our kind and generous friends and sponsors who have donated to this event and supported the sisters. I would like to take a moment to thank everyone who helped to make this event possible. Kathy Barth, the director of our development office, Rachel Neubauer, the director of our communication office, and very special gratitude to Heidi Scheuer and Amanda Gerentano for their time, talent, and amazing creativity in coordinating this evening's social Sweet Memories. If you haven't yet and would like to make a donation, there's still time. Please click on the link below to visit our donation page. We appreciate your generous support. God bless all of you who joined us for this stay-at-home social. Our sisters recall many sweet memories and hold all of you in prayer each day. Our promise of prayer for you will never change. May the words of our Mother Foundress remain with you as we close this event. Let the faith be your guiding light. Thank you, God bless, and have a good evening.